All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Oh, man. Thank you guys very much for joining me. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Man, I try to do it live for you guys, people. Try to break it all down from the pros to college, UFC. Just had that fight. Let's break this thing down. This one is about the Ducks. Duck basketball is on a roll right now. Cruising. Got the 10, 12, maybe 11 games in a row they've won right now. They've got the 34, 35 game home winning streak. They are kicking butt right now. So let's go ahead and talk about these guys. Super excited about it. We'll wrap this thing up. Go check out any of the other videos if we can. Update when I can, what I can for all you guys. Oregon football and the like. So Duck basketball, huge. UCLA we'll start it off with. Then we'll talk about USC a little bit. Then we'll look ahead to next week with the Washington schools. First and foremost, UCLA. Crazy history of UCLA in Oregon. Goes all the way back to the Bill Walton days. Bill Walton in the 70s had the tough time, had the Sports Illustrated cover where it's famous, the lost trail of Oregon or whatever. Anyway, Bill Walton had a really tough time down here. Fast forward to the 80s, and you had a really tough time with Reggie Miller. Reggie Miller lost in that building. I was there. I saw that one at Matt Court. Kofi Shea dunking on him at the end of the game. Fast forward, you look ahead to Aaron Brooks era. Aaron Brooks right back here. You look at the Freddie era with Luke and Luke. And then you go ahead and transfer forward a little bit more to this late run where we had some pretty good success and actually won at Pauley last year as well. So the idea for me about this UCLA thing is UCLA has been the premier program in the conference since day one. But you know what? After John Wooden, they've only won one championship, and that came in the 90s. Arizona has been the premier program for about the last maybe 20 years or so, on and off with UCLA as well. It really feels like Oregon's that third team now. It really feels like Oregon solidified itself. Washington is a phenomenal program. They've had a pretty good amount of success. They've had really good players, super high-end, like NBA players go through there, but they really haven't translated into a lot of wins or Pac-12 championships. Oregon has been in the running for the Pac-12 championship three or four of the last years. Really had a really good run with Ernie Kent. So I really feel like when we're talking about Oregon basketball, in the same conversation we were talking about with Oregon football, where really trying to get a foothold on the conference and try to get a namesake for, this is one of the better teams of the conference, not just now, but in the last five, last 10, and, you know, historically have been competitive, Duck basketball much more than Duck football. So UCLA, huge victory, huge shot, absolutely signature victory for that building. Matt Court, I was a big fan of. When you move over to Matt Knight, you know, it's a huge barn. It looks like a mini Rose Garden. It's just, it feels pretty empty. This was a huge event. You filled it up. You filled it up on a Wednesday night with no students. That's really big. To fill that barn up, you really got to have local people come there. You can't rely on people coming from Portland to go down there on a Wednesday night and fill that thing up. Obviously, with vacation, you had an opportunity, but knowing the UCLA was as good as they were, you knew they were going to come in ready to play. God, it was an exciting one, and that was a huge, huge victory. So, first of all, let's talk about the game a little bit. Looked like Oregon was in charge the whole game until you got that freshman for UCLA, started that Lonzo Ball. He does look a lot like Jason Kidd to me. He's just a dominator. The kid is really silky smooth. He hits those back-to-back threes. They go ahead. That looked like a danger zone. Then you get a couple other shots in there. He hits another three. The coach's kid hits another three, I think, in there as well. All of a sudden, you're down by like 10 or 8. To be able to have that transition at the very end there where Peyton Pritchard hit that three, that is a huge, huge shot. Gets you back in the situation. You go down. You miss the free throw. To come back, again, I was talking to my son about this. I got a son who's a 10-year-old. And I'm his basketball coach, and we're talking about, do you go the old school routine, you go by the book, or do you go kind of this new age way of doing things on the last second shot? One shot to get it, 1 point to get it. The old school way is you get to the rim. You're going to try to draw contact, maybe you get to the foul line, you got multiple options, kind of like the the running the option in football. You know, you got multiple plays out of something. You can make something out of nothing if it comes to that. These guys nowadays, they look for the three-pointer to win it. Now, obviously, a much lower percentage shot, but at least you're able to get it off when and kind of where you want it. As opposed to when you go to the rim, you're kind of subjected to how the defense plays you, how you get that shot off. So, obviously, you go to the rim, look to try to get maybe some contact. Hopefully, maybe look to try to deliver some of the contact, use some of it, get free. But it takes a pretty good player to get that ball off at the end. And getting close to the rim isn't necessarily a guarantee, because a lot of times the ref's going to swallow the whistle at the end of the game. You aren't even going to get the foul. They're going to get the contact. They're going to get to hammer you, and probably the chances of you then making that shot go down. That same shot in the third quarter, you get an easy foul on, make two free throws. You go to the free throw line at the end of the fourth quarter with 0-0 on the clock or 0.8 or whatever, and now all of a sudden your heart's pumping, the hands are sweating, and all of a sudden you don't make that shot. So the kid who was an 87% free throw shooter, the kid whose dad's the coach, Alford, he missed the shot. So it's not a guarantee, right? Let me get a sip here real quick. That fresh Oregon Portland water. Boy, we love it. So huge victory for the Ducks. Really not surprising to me. Oregon is a great team this year. We knew Oregon was going to be a good team this year. Just going to take time to gel. Dylan Brooks coming off of a foot injury. That's a big deal. He missed 5-6 weeks, maybe even longer, completely out of playing basketball. That's going to take some time. You lose two guys off the team last year that were really key players. That Benjamin was a key guy, sixth man, great defensive player. And then Cook was just a go-to, steady Eddie player. Gave you some height, gave you scoring option down low. You know, the big men down low don't score too much for the Ducks right now. So getting a transition of trying to figure out this new team, plus you add Peyton Pritchard to the situation, which is changes up the point guard rotation a tremendous amount. So there's lots of stuff to kind of work through here. They really look good right now. The defense really looks good right now. The press looks good. They switch so well between the zone, man-to-man. They're really effortless on defense. They really have length. They've got some extra help there with Bigby Williams. You're looking at a great year this year. Now, if the rest of the conference shapes up the way it looks right now, it's still going to be a pretty tough conference. You know, the Beavs do not look that good, but they played UCLA pretty tough today. You know, Cal is always tough. Washington has NBA players on it through and through. Washington State will kind of see about. They've got the one tall kid. You know, they've got some other players up there. But, you know, other than that, the conference is pretty stacked. USC, UCLA both came into this weekend undefeated. Arizona's always good. Arizona State's always got talent. You know, and then you got the mountain schools, you know. And those mountain schools, Utah's been really good lately. And Colorado's been in the goddamn NCAA tournament for probably 6 or 7 of the last 8 years. So I would not mess with the Pac-12 at all. Whoever comes out of the Pac-12 is going to be tried and true big time. So you move on to the USC game today. What happened? This was just a blowout. I mean, it was early on. It was a good game, but then Oregon just hit the Jets, blew them out, and really was on the defensive end. They stopped USC tremendously on the defensive end. Not much to say about that game other than the fact that looks like Boucher's healthy again, which was kind of a concern. He hurt himself in a practice. And then Dylan Brooks, just the kind of the evolution of trying to get him back, get him comfortable in the offense. Now, this looking forward, Washington schools this week. I'm going to try to do a video maybe every once a week. I'll try to just recap it, what happens. The Washington schools is a tricky one. Washington is a hell of a school. That team, Renzo Romar, great coach, quality program. But I don't know how or why, or I don't know what their deal is, but they get players. They get absolute top flight, just unbelievable ballers, okay? They got a freshman right now who's projected to be the number one pick in the draft next year, okay? And so Markel Fultz, and this kid is just unreal. And they have David Crisp, Dickerson, other guys on that team that can score. Carlos Johnson. But you know what? I don't understand what the deal is with this Washington team. With the amount of talent they have, it could be the fact that you've got the one-and-done philosophy there where you don't really have kids understanding really what's going on. It's kind of a me-first thing, and then that really doesn't equate to too many wins. I don't know. But they started the year off this year really tough with a loss to Yale. I mean, when I saw that, I was like, what? And Yale put like 98 points on them. Okay. They lost back-to-back games to TCU. Now, I don't know how good TCU is, but then I watched the Gonzaga game, and they pretty much got blown out in the Gonzaga game. So I really don't know how good this team is. It seems like when they play a lesser team, they get the victory. But right now, any team that is above Seattle University or Cal Poly, they're struggling with. So I think Oregon might have some trouble with some of their players individually, but as a team and as a unit, I think Oregon is just going to wear them out. Now, Washington State, I don't know as much about, but Washington State, again, is one of those schools. Ernie Kent, I love Ernie Kent to death, but is one of those teams with you never really know what you're going to get until about halfway through the season with them. And at the end of the season, they usually end up right around 500, and you see kind of glimpses where there were games they played really well and other games where they just didn't even show up at all and got blown out. So I kind of think that Washington State and Washington, I feel like Oregon's going to win both those games. Probably struggle a little more with Washington than Washington State, but I don't think it's that going to be that big of a problem. I really feel like Oregon's gelling right now. And again, they're winning on the defensive side. They're winning with length. They're winning with transition buckets. They're winning with turnovers. They're getting easy buckets offensively. And you know what? That game against UCLA, they have their starting five all averages 15 points. That team's going to score. So don't worry about that UCLA game. That game's going to be the one to circle again on the calendar. Hopefully we get to play them again, even in the Pac-12 tournament, because as a fan, I just want to see that over and over and over. If we get three games with UCLA this year, that'd be phenomenal. So thank you guys for watching. Happy New Year, everybody. Go check out those other videos if you're interested. And other than that, everybody, man, let's get out of here and enjoy it. Adios, everybody. Sports Chat 503.